some music.
Now there's a good idea.
I'll get the record player.
Here, let's clear this stuff out. Here, make yourself useful.
Say, does anyone know what time it is?
About 9:30, I guess.
Oh, sorry I can't stay for the music, friends, but I have an English test tomorrow, and, as usual, I'm not ready for an English test tomorrow.
But it isn't even 10 o'clock yet.
Yeah, well, look, Paul's English test is my English test, too, so I guess I better get going.
Say, can you stop over at my place for a few minutes and go over my English notes with me?
Yeah, I guess so.
You know the part we did on
Now, there's a couple of real swingers.
So, look, it's only Tuesday, and there's no way my mother will go along with anything after 11:30 on a school night.
And on Fridays and Saturdays, you go all snaky and stay up till midnight?
Try me.
Oh, I didn't mean it. I mean, I was just joking. Every time I open my big mouth.
You busy Friday?
No, but...
No, but you and I have a big date Friday, okay?
Okay.
I've got to go. Dave?
Yeah, okay then. Well, we'll see you later, Carol.
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Way to go, Carol. That's the way to make the big impression. Keep this up and he'll be throwing rocks at you in no time. Oh boy, the only guy in the whole school who isn't a creep. And he's available. So, what do? Right away, you ruin the whole thing.
Well, what do you think?
Guess I managed to ruin a perfectly good Tuesday evening night for just about everybody, eh?
Ruined it? What do you mean, ruined it? It worked, didn't it?
What worked?
Look, the point is, you're going out with Paul Friday night, aren't you?
Yeah, but the way it happened, figures he'll think of something to get out of it, like getting a hangnail.
No way. I know Paul well enough to know he's intrigued.
Man, that girl's really something, isn't she?
Yeah, well, she had you going there for a while.
Well, you gotta admit, she does come on a little bit like gangbusters.
Yeah, and you jump right into a neat little trap.
What?
Friday night, I mean.
That was my idea.
Oh, yeah, old buddy. Your idea all the way.
Ah, forget it. Say, you and Nancy doing anything on Friday?
Like what?
Oh, I don't know, like going to the movies or something.
Can't afford it.
Can't afford it?
Nope. Well, Wednesday's Nancy's birthday. I want to buy her something. And then Friday's the school dance. I got a budget to loot, man. I just can't make it.
Ah, come on up and I'll show you my notes at English test.
Isn't it too late?
Not for scores. Mom will probably give me a little static.
Going steady has got to be a drag. Fine birthday presents, and there's no way you can get out of going in the school dance. I don't know, man. I just can't see it.
Yeah, well, you just don't know what you're missing. Well, when you really like somebody, the way I like Nancy, and you want to buy birthday presents, you want to go to the school dance. It's not something you do because you have to. Well, come on, let's go look at those English notes. I could talk about going steady all night, and you still wouldn't understand.
Yeah, but it does cause money problems. Here, grab a chair. So I'll spring for the tickets if you and Nancy will come on Friday.
Nah, I don't think Nancy'd go for that.
Could be, you might need a little moral support come Friday.
Could be.
In that case, I guess Nancy wouldn't mind.
Yeah, David and I talk over everything. Of course, we've been going together for nearly a year now.
I was going steady before we moved here, but it wasn't like that. I went out with Frank a few times, but then we moved. I guess it wouldn't have come to anything anyway. I only missed Frank because I didn't have anyone else to go out with.
Well, so far, Paul thinks going steady's for the birds. I keep saying it's only because he hasn't met the right girl. But David doesn't think so. He says when I talk like that, I'm only making noises like a female.
Who knows? But let's face it, Paul is cute. Anyway, I better get going.
Too bad they asked the girl.
Thanks for asking me over tonight. It's kind of lonely, you know, living in a new place. I went to a couple of things at school, but I went by myself. I felt so strange I didn't stay long enough to get to know anybody.
Well, you know, I can't imagine living any place else. I've lived here all my life, and now, of course, there's David. I wouldn't want to move away from where he is.
I have an idea he feels exactly the same way.
Guess that's the way it should be. I don't really know what going steady's all about, I suppose.
Well, all I can say is, for me, it's terrific.
Nancy and David have been going together almost a year, and they think it's terrific. Is it? What do you think? Are Nancy's parents beginning to think it's time she tried dating others besides David? What would your parents say? What are some of the implications of going with one person for more than a year? What happens if they break up? Paul says going steady is a drag, and he means it. Is he being forced into a situation he doesn't want by pressure imposed by his friends? Dating is important in the development of your relationship with the opposite sex, as well as in your own development as a person. What do you think is the best way for you to participate? By going steady with just one person, or by playing the field and dating many different people?